Hey guys, the other week I posted up a small write-up about standard refrigerant hoses and do they collapse in a vacuum or restrict in a vacuum. So today I'm going to try to bust that myth. And what I've done here is I've got my Robinair vacuum pump. It's beat up, but it still chugs along quite nicely. I've got my Testo 557 digital manifold, and I have a standard quarter inch refrigerant charging hose hooked up to my vacuum pump, and on the other end I've got my vacuum probe. So what I did is I marked out the midpoint of the hose exactly in the middle, and I took a reading, and my reading was 0.438 thousandths of an inch. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn this pump on, we're going to get the hose into a deep vacuum, and we're going to take a measurement of the hose at the midpoint where I marked it and see if there's any difference. So let's get the pump started and we'll check it in a few minutes. Okay, so we're down into a deep vacuum, 213 microns. I mean, that's a pretty solid vacuum there. And I've still got my caliper here at 0.438 thousandths of an inch. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to slide it over top of the hose. If we still have a nice snug fit, I think we've busted the myth. If I need to adjust that caliper in a little bit, we might have a possible restriction or collapsing of the hose. So let's go ahead and try that. So there you can see my spot that's marked off with the marker. We're going to go and slide that right over top, and nice snug fit. Didn't have to adjust that at all. So we're still at 0.438 thousandths of an inch. So it appears that this quarter inch hose, which is easily 5 years old, has not collapsed or restricted whatsoever. I think this myth for now is busted. I'm going to turn the vacuum pump off. We're going to put the hose back to atmosphere and we're going to check it again. So our pump's now off. We're going to release the hose from the pump, and now our hose is back at atmosphere. And we don't even have a micron reading anymore. So our hose is at atmosphere. And what we're going to do is go back to the midpoint of the hose and slide the caliper back on. So again, slides on, nice snug fit. I didn't adjust it whatsoever, and we're still at 0.438 thousandths of an inch. So, like I said, I think we've busted this myth for now. If any of you guys have experienced anything different with your hoses, let me know. That was a cool little experiment I thought of to check this out, and apparently, hoses don't collapse in a vacuum. Thanks for watching, guys.